নমস্কার, সুস্বাগতম। আলোর আলপেন সংস্থার পক্ষ থেকে আমরা আপনাদের স্বাগত জানাই। আমরা চেষ্টা করছি পশ্চিমবঙ্গ বোর্ডের মাধ্যমিক বোর্ডে ছাত্রছাত্রীদের জন্য কিছু মেটেরিয়ালস ডিজিটাইজড করতে। ইংরেজিতে শুরু করেছি আমরা, পরে অন্যগুলো করতে। আমাদের উদ্দেশ্য হচ্ছে একটাই, শিক্ষা উন্মুক্ত, যেখানে খুশি, যখন খুশি, যতবার খুশি। আপনি যেখানে আপনার সোনামণি ছেলের বা মেয়ে তার প্রাইভেট টিউটর, পার্সোনাল টিউটর সেখানে। আশা করি আমাদের প্রচেষ্টা আপনার ভালো লাগে। ওকে, চলে যাক। বাটারফ্লাই করা হচ্ছে, আমরা চেষ্টা করছি। ভয়েস বা এটা তিলোত্তমা রে, মেমোরি ইন মার্ব, worried, he came back home in the evening and asked his grandfather, "Grandfather, can you tell me something about Taj Mahal?" Worried, he came back home in the evening and asked his grandfather. Grandfather, Can you tell me something about Taj Mahal? Tarun's grandfather was a retired teacher. Tarun's grandfather was a retired teacher. He knew a lot about this beautiful monument. He smiled and said, "Okay, if you promise to be a good boy, I will tell you many things about the Taj." Amra bolchi orid orid, he came back
home in the evening and asked his grandfather, "Grandfather, can you tell me something about Taj Mahal?" Tarun's grandfather was a retired teacher. He knew a lot about this beautiful monument. He smiled and said, "Okay, if you promise to be a good boy, I will tell you many things about the Taj." Tarun promised not to be naughty. So his grandfather began to tell him the story of Taj Mahal. Tarun promised not to be naughty. So his grandfather began to tell him the story of the Taj Mahal.
Once upon a time, there lived a prince named Khurram. He was the son of Jahangir and the grandson of Akbar the Great. One day, Khurram went to the Meena Bazaar with his friends. There he caught a glimpse of an extremely beautiful girl who was selling silk and glass beads. The girl was Arjumand Banu Begum. Once upon a time, there lived a prince named Khurram. He was the son of Jahangir and the grandson of Akbar the Great. One day, Khurram went to the Meena Bazaar with his friends. There he caught a glimpse of an extremely beautiful girl who was selling silk and glass beads. The girl was Arjumand Banu Begum. She was born in a family of a Persian nobility. After meeting her, Khurram went back to his father and said that he wanted to marry her. Khurram married Arjumand Banu Begum in 1612. Five years after their first meeting. So I'm reading it out once again. She was born in a family of a Persian nobility. After meeting her, Khurram went back to his father and said that he wanted to marry her. Khurram married Arjumand Banu Begum in 1612, 5 years after their first meeting. At this point, Tarun stopped his grandfather. "But grandfather, I don't want to hear the story of Prince Khurram. I want to know about the Taj Mahal. Be patient, Tarun. Let me finish the whole story, said his grandfather. All right, said Tarun. His grandfather continued with the story. Prince Khurram was later known as Shah Jahan. He became the emperor in the year 1628. Arjuman Begum was later renamed as Mumtaz Mahal. But what does the name Mumtaz Mahal mean? Asked Tarun. It means the brightest crown of the world, answered his grandfather. So, Prince Khurram was later known as Shah Jahan. He became the emperor in the year 1628, Arjuman Banu Begum was later renamed as Mumtaz Mahal. But what does the name Mumtaz Mahal mean? Asked Tarun. It means the brightest crown of the world, answered his grandfather. Then he continued with his tale. When Mumtaz was on her deathbed, Shah Jahan promised her that he would not marry again. He also promised her that he would build the most beautiful mausoleum over her grave. When Mumtaz was on her deathbed, Shah Jahan promised her that he would not marry again. He also promised her that he would build the most beautiful mausoleum over her grave. What is a mausoleum, grandfather? Asked Tarun in surprise. Oh, a mausoleum is a building built to house the dead, said grandfather. According to legends, Shah Jahan was so sad after her death that he ordered the court to mourn for 2 years. Later, Shah Jahan started to build the world's most beautiful monument beside the river Yamuna in memory of his beloved wife. It took 22 years and 22,000 workers to build the monument. The Taj Mahal was built entirely out of white marble. So, according to legends, Shah Jahan was so sad after her death that he ordered the court to mourn for 2 years. Later, Shah Jahan started to build the world's most beautiful monument beside the river Yamuna in memory of his beloved wife. It took 22 years and 22,000 workers to build the monument. the Taj Mahal was built entirely out of white marble. This white marble was brought in from all over Asia. When Shah Jahan died in 1666, his body was placed next to the grave of Mumtaz Mahal. This magnificent monument came to be known as the Taj Mahal. It is now considered to be one among the seven wonders of the world. Grandfather paused for a moment. Well, I have told you quite a lot today. Will this be helpful enough? Will this be helpful enough? So, this white marble was brought in from all over Asia. When Shah Jahan died in 1666, his body was placed next to the grave of Mumtaz Mahal. This magnificent monument came to be known as the Taj Mahal. It is now considered to be one among the seven wonders of the world. Grandfather paused for a moment. Well, I have told you quite a lot today. Will this be helpful enough? Oh yes, now I can easily write a paragraph on the Taj Mahal, said Tarun happily.